Hello, and thank you for watching. My name is Rachel Barnett with Gentle Frog. I'm here to create videos for you to help you understand QuickBooks slightly better than you currently do. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, please put them in the chat box. Thank you.
In this video, I want to talk to you about retained earnings. If you don't want to watch the whole video where I explain it, very simply, retained earnings is the sum of all previous years' net income or net losses. QuickBooks is going to add up what it knows. So if you started your business 20 years ago and you started using QuickBooks 5 years ago, your retained earnings is going to be the sum of all of the last 5 years' net income or net losses, because that's all QuickBooks knows. In this video, I'm going to detail it and show you how this works, just so you can see the behind the scenes and see what you can click on and what you can't click on and what happens. Let me just show you how I got here. This is the balance sheet. I just picked today's date. I'm recording this just after the middle of February 2025. If I scroll down, QuickBooks says my retained earnings is $23.16. I know you can't really tell, but I'm trying to click on it and I can't. So let me show you on the chart of accounts how this looks. So if I were to search for retained earnings, I can run a report, but I don't see the register, which means that I can't go into the register like you can go in the checking register and change things. I'm gonna change it to say all dates, and it says this report doesn't contain any data. And then I'm gonna take a step back and be like, how does it contain no data if just a moment ago I saw a number? And the answer is it's magic behind the scenes. So let me show you the magic behind the scenes. This is my balance sheet for all dates. So basically I'm just saying QuickBooks, show me everything that is in my QuickBooks and subdivide it by years. So now I scroll down and my retained earnings is $0 back in 2015. It goes to negative $15 and it stays that way until 2024. And then in 2025, it changes. I must have been doing some example back in 2015 because I would bet there's just the one entry, but that doesn't matter. What I want you to see is, first of all, you don't, as the user, do anything to make retained earnings happen or get a number. QuickBooks is doing this automatically. The number is coming from the profit and loss. What it's saying is QuickBooks says, all right, on your profit and loss every year, you have a net income. And so the net income for 2015 is negative $15. And then there's $0 of income and then negative $18. The net income shows up on the balance sheet right here as net income. So you see it in 2015, net income matches the profit and loss. Then at the beginning of the year, the net income adds to whatever the number was in retained earnings. So 0 plus negative 15 equals negative 15. The net income here is $0 all the way up until 2023. If you look at that on your profit and loss, it's $0 until 2023. When we get to 2023, we have a net income of $18. Now we've already learned the retained earnings is the previous cumulative retained earnings plus the current net income. So negative 15 plus negative 18 equals negative 33. The net income in 2024 is 2349. Let's just verify that on the profit and loss, 2349. So that's what's happening. I'm recording this video. I don't know why it stops with February 6th, because I'm recording this on February 17th, but that doesn't matter. Your net income is going to pull from the profit and loss. And then at the end of the year, when January 1st rolls around, the money transfers from the net income line and adds into the retained earnings line. You, as the business owner or the bookkeeper, you don't need to do anything to make that happen. It happens automatically within QuickBooks. The retained earnings is the sum of all previous years' net income or net losses. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to let me know. All right, thanks.